Friends, welcome. I welcome you to my channel. Today I am going to take up design of couplings, design of shaft couplings. Shaft couplings. First of all, what is a coupling? See, I already told while discussing about the design of shaft in theory, I told this, the shafts come in standard length of 6 meters. So L is 6 meters. If I want to have a shaft longer than this, the only alternative is to join two or more shafts so that I can get the required length. Now, for at every joint, we have to use a shaft coupling to couple the shafts. To couple two shafts, we require a coupling, that is called as the coupling, shaft coupling. Now, you can see this coupling normally, generally, most of you in cities, in urban areas, you have a pump set in the home for pumping water from the sump to the overhead tank. There, that pump has two units. One is the motor and the other one is the pump. The shaft of the motor and the shaft of the pump are coupled by means of a coupling. Generally, a flange coupling is used there. In rural places, you have these pump sets, irrigation pump sets. There also, you will have a motor, you will have a pump. Now, the two shafts, that is the shaft of the motor and the shaft of the pump, are coupled together by means of a flange coupling. Or if you go to your hydraulics lab, generally in hydraulics labs, you have kits nowadays. There also you have a centrifugal pump which is connected to the motor shaft. The pump shaft and the motor shaft are coupled by means of a flange coupling. That is the place where you can see very commonly a flange coupling being used. Now, this, we have in our syllabus two couplings. They are the muff, or it is also called as sleeve coupling, and the other one is the flange coupling. Now, both these couplings are rigid couplings used to couple shafts whose axes are collinear. Both the shafts are collinear and both are of same diameter. Both the shafts to be connected are of same diameter. Now, here first I will take up a design of muff coupling. Here we use what we call a muff or a sleeve, which is nothing but a hollow cylindrical casting, generally of cast steel or cast iron. Now, it will be like this. If I take a sectional view, it will be like this. A hollow casting with a hole here in the center. This hole will be same diameter as the dia of the shaft which is to be connected. Now, one shaft will be inserted from this side. And it will be keyed to this. It will be keyed here. One key will be used. The other shaft will be inserted from here. And this will be keyed here. There will be a keyway here and the key will be placed here at 90 degrees they will be placed. So this is in general this thing. Now this is the dia of shaft. We know how to find out. This we already have discussed. Again, you have to find the dia of the shaft. This is what we call the muff or the sleeve. Here two dimensions are to be found out. One is its outer dia. Inner dia is already fixed. So the outer dia and length. Here this length is not very important because it is never going to fail this way. It is never going to break this way. If at all it breaks, it is going to break this way only. So this diameter is important. Now D will be equal to 2D plus 13 mm, 2D plus 13 mm, or sometimes they use 2D also, and L will be equal to 3.5D, like this. So you have to check it. Once you have designed this by using this formula, we have to check this. We check this as a hollow shaft transmitting same torque as the torque transmitted by the shafts connected by it. So we'll have the formula T is equal to pi d cube outer dia 16 into 1 minus k to the power of 4 into tau muff shear stress. So tau muff will be equal to 16 T max divided by pi d cube into 1 minus k to the power of 4. That formula gives us this thing. The formula are available, so you need not remember those formula. The formula are available to you in this thing, but you, the notations that are used will be different in different design data handbooks by different authors. Now we will take up a problem on design of this coupling, muff coupling. I'll take up one problem from the question bank again. Question number 2. There are only 2 questions. I have selected question number 2. The problem is like this. Design a muff coupling to connect 2 shafts. Design a muff coupling to connect 2 shafts transmitting. Design a muff coupling to transmit to connect 2 shafts transmitting 40 kilowatt at 350 rpm. The material for the shaft and key is plain carbon steel, for which allowable shear and crushing stresses may be taken as 40 megapascal and 80 megapascal respectively. Sorry, this is 30 megapascal and 80 megapascal respectively. Full stop. The material of the muff is cast iron with permissible shear stress, tau muff material, that is CI, is 15 megapascal or 15 newton per mm square. Assume that the maximum torque is T max is 25% greater, that means 1.25 times mean torque, greater than the mean torque. So this is the given data. Now first what we have to find out is, we have to find out T, that is the torque, maximum torque, that will be 9.55 P divided by N into 10 to the power of 6, so many newton mm. So this is to be found out. This is the mean torque, 9.55 into 40 divided by 350 into 10 to the power of 6, that is 9.55 into 40 divided by 350 is 1.09 something into 10 to the power of 6 newton mm. This is the mean torque. He has said take maximum torque as 1.25 times. So maximum torque will be 1.25 times T, that is 25% greater than T. So 1.25 into 1.09 into 10 to the power of 6. So this multiplied by 1.25, that I get 1.36. 1.36 or 37 you can take Newton mm. This is the maximum torque. So you have to design it for that torque. So first what you have to do is design of shaft. Design of shaft. So that means you have to find out the dia of shaft. D will be equal to 16 T max divided by pi into tau shaft. Tau of shaft is same as the tau of key. Both key and shaft are made of same material. So these are the stresses for that. So 16 into T max is 1.36 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by pi into shaft. Tau is 30 whole to the power of 1 by 3. Now this into 16 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by pi divided by 30 is something like this, 231608 cube root of answer. Answer will give me 61.41 mm. I'll go to the data handbook, take the standard value. Standard dia of shaft is after 60, the next size available is 65. So adopt dia of shaft, it is fixed now as 65 mm. So dia of shaft is 65 mm. Next, design of key. Design of key. First, the width and thickness. From, you have to take it for this dia, for 65 mm. The width is 20 mm, length is, thickness is 12 mm. Now length is 3.5D divided by 2 or 1.75D. So 3.5 into 65 divided by 2, 3.5 into 65 divided by 2, 113.75, 113.75 mm, say 120 mm. 120 mm. This is design of key. Now check the key check for induced stresses in the key. So shear stress induced in the key will be 2 T max divided by DLW, that is 2 into 1.36 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by D is 65. L we have taken as, I have taken it as 120 into width is 20 mm. So 2 into 1.36 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by 65 divided by 120 divided by 20 will give me 17.4 Newton per mm square. It is less than this, so fine, no problem. Then crushing stress induced in the key 4T max divided by DLT, that is 4 into 1.36 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by 65 into 120 into 12. 4 into 1.36 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by 65 divided by 120 divided by 12 will give me 58 point something, 58.2, let us say, Newton per mm square. Now this is less than this. So you have to write here, since the induced stresses in the key are less than the permissible values given, the design of key is safe. Since the induced stresses in the key both are less than the given permissible values, the design of key is safe. Permissible values, the design of key, that means the dimensions are satisfactory of key, is safe. We need not increase anything, let it be like that. Next, design of muff. Design of muff, outer dia of muff, design of muff, outer dia, that is capital D is 2D plus 13, that is 2 into 65, 130 plus 13, that is 143 mm. Length of muff, L is 3.5D, that is 3.5 into 65, 3.5 into 65 will give us 227.5 mm. So let it be like that, it's not important. Then check for induced shear stress, only shear stress in muff. Now the formula will be shear stress in the muff, shear stress in the muff, tau muff will be equal to 16 T max divided by pi D to the power of 3 into 1 minus K to the power of 4. K is inner dia by outer dia. Inner dia is 65, outer dia is 143. So 65 by 143 divided by 143 gives me 0.45. So substitute that here, 16 into 1.36 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by pi, outer dia is 143 cube into 1 minus 0.45 to the power of 4. How much does it give us? 1 minus 0.45 to the power of 4 equals multiplied by 143 to the power of 3 multiplied by pi gives 880.9956 something. Now 16 into 1.36 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by this answer here, which I have, sir, is equal to 2.47. This works out to 2.47 Newton per mm square. The permissible stress given is 15 megapascal. We are getting 2.47 megapascal, so therefore it is safe. So you have to write, since same thing, the induced shear stress in the muff is less than the given permissible value, the design of muff is safe. So this is how the problem is to be done on muff coupling. This is the solution for the problem which is given. Next we take up the procedure for design of flange coupling. Design of flange coupling. Now here the steps are same, the procedure is same. First we have to design the shaft. Design the shaft means we have to find the dia of the shaft. We have to find the dia of the shaft. Generally it will be solid shaft. We have to find the dia of the shaft. Then based on that, design the key. Design the key means there are two keys. Actually there are two shafts, but both of same diameter. So if you design one, the design is the other is also designed. Now design the key means we have to find out W, T and L, width, thickness and length of the key. So we know already how to do it. Same procedure we have done even in muff coupling. Then check the key, check the keys for induced stresses. Yes, this also we have done, same procedure. Then design the flanges. There will be two flanges here. Design the flanges. Then check the flanges, check the flanges for induced stresses. Then the procedure from here is different. Then design the bolts. Here you get bolts. We have to design the bolts. One bolt if you design, all the bolts are designed. So flange, you know, a flange will come like this. If it is unprotected type, it will come like this. This is unprotected type. Flange will come like this. Now there will be a hole here. There will be holes here also for accommodating the bolts. There will be one more. The shaft will be passed from here and it will be keyed. One shaft. The shaft will be passed here from and keyed. Another shaft in the other one will be keyed. Now this is same as, this hole is same as dia of the shaft. So that we know how to find out, so that dia is fixed. In design of flange, what you have to do is, we have to find out these things. What we have to find out, outer dia of hub. Outer dia of hub, capital D. that is this one. This is capital D. Then length of hub. Length of hub, L, that is this one. This is L. Length of hub. Then thickness of flange. Thickness of flange, that is TF, that is this one, TF. Then this dia, pitch circle dia, it is called D1, pitch circle dia of bolts. Pitch circle dia of bolts D1. Then outer dia of the flange, this one, that will be D2. Different books give different dimensions. D1, this is outer flange, outer dia of flange, dia of flange, D2. Then number of bolts. All these will be designed by empirical formulae, and they all depend upon this D, dia of the shaft. So this is the most important dimension. If you get D correctly, if our dia of shaft is correct, everything else will automatically be correct. So this will be 2 times D. This will be 1.5 times D. This will be 0.5 times D. This will be 3D. This will be 4D. And number of bolts, this is N. In some, it will be given as I in some design data handbook. This depends upon again D. If N will be equal to 3 minimum, if D is less than or equal to 40 mm, it will be equal to 4. If it is more than 40, less than or equal to 100 mm, that is up to 100 mm, it will be 4. It will be 6 if D is greater than 100 mm, less than or equal to 180 mm, like this. It will be usually 3, 4 or 6, this thing. One extra calculation will come in protected type. If it is protected type flange coupling, thickness of protective flange is equal to 0.25 D or D by 4, 0.25 into small d, that is dia of the shaft. All these things, it is only in case of protected type flange coupling. Protected type flange coupling. Okay, all these, this thing you will get from the design data handbook. You need not have to remember anything here. But what are the things? These are the things to be found out, and you will have to find out, calculate those things. Then you have to check. See, here this may break like this. The hub, it may break like this. It will be like a hollow shaft. You have to check it for that. Or it may break here also, it can break, that is, that way also it can shear. So you have to check for those two things there. How to check it? The formula will be given, or there in the, not given, they will be there in the this thing. So for checking this type of fracture, this type of failure, that is the hollow shaft formula. Shear stress induced in the hub is 16 T max divided by pi D cube into 1 minus k to the power of 4, so many newton per mm square. Tau flange will be equal to 2 T by pi D square into TF, that is for this type of failure. And then after that, you have to design the bolts. Design of bolts. Here you have to find out the dia of the bolt, nominal dia of the bolt. design of bolts. This is check for this thing, induced stresses, design of bolts. For that, the formula is T is equal to, that is T max, whenever we say T, it is maximum torque, is equal to N, number of bolts, pi D square by 4, area of each bolt into number of bolts into tau bolt into D1, that is this one, pitch circle dia of bolt divided by 2. This, from this formula, you can call this as D1 or DB. D1 is dia of bolt, and that is what you have to find out. Here bolts are subjected to, this is permissible shear stress for bolt material. Bolts are subjected to shear here. Normally we don't subject bolts to shear. This is an exceptional case. Flange coupling is an exceptional case where the bolts are subjected to shear, and they are designed by this formula. Here this D1 or DB, whatever you want you can call, this is the dia of the bolt. In mm you will get it. These are the formula that will be used in the design of flange coupling.